أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
قاف والقرآن المجيد.
قاف by the honored Quran.
قاف والقرآن المجيد. The second surah starting with one letter قاف. We had once surah صاد. The second is this. والقرآن المجيد by the glorious Quran. And here again you think we but the this oath is taken on what? إِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. I told you just as we had in Surah Yasin, everywhere you should feel that that ayah is understood here. والقرآن المجيد by this glorious Quran, verily O Muhammad, you are the messenger of Allah. That ayah is understood here.
بَلْ عَجِبُوا أَن جَاءَهُمْ مُنذِرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَقَالَ الْكَافِرُونَ هَذَا شَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ.
But they wonder that there has come to them a warner from among themselves, and the disbelievers say, this is an amazing thing.
بَلْ عَجِبُوا أَن جَاءَهُمْ مُنذِرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَقَالَ الْكَافِرُونَ هَذَا شَيْءٌ عَجِيبٌ. But they are wondering that a warner has come to them from among themselves. So the disbelievers say, this is a very strange thing. How can a human being a warner from Allah? And so, more strange.
أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا ذَلِكَ رَجْعٌ بَعِيدٌ.
When we have died and have become dust, we will return to life. That is a distant return.
إِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا ذَلِكَ رَجْعٌ بَعِيدٌ. Shall we be resurrected again? When we shall have died and became clay and dust and nothing else will remain from us. Well, this returning again to life is beyond any imagination. رجعون بعيد.
قد علمنا ما تنقص الأرض منهم وعندنا كتاب حفيظ.
We know what the earth diminishes of them, and with us is a retaining record.
قد علمنا ما تنقص الأرض منهم. We very well know what the earth diminishes from them. وعندنا كتاب حفيظ. And we have a book which has the total record of everything.
بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِالْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ فَهُمْ فِي أَمْرٍ مَرِيجٍ.
But they denied the truth when it came to them, so they are in a confused condition.
بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِالْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ. But they have belied the truth when it has come to them. فَهُمْ فِي أَمْرِ مَرِيجٍ. So now they are confused in this matter.
أَفَلَمْ يَنْظُرُوا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَوْقَهُمْ كَيْفَ بَنَيْنَاهَا وَزَيَّنَّاهَا وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ فُرُوجٍ.
Have they not looked at the heaven above them? How we structured it and adorned it and how it has no rifts?
أَفَلَمْ يَنْظُرُوا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَوْقَهُمْ. Don't they see to the sky over them, to the heaven over them? كَيْفَ بَنَيْنَاهَا. How have we constructed it? وَزَيَّنَّاهَا. And then adorned it. وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ فُرُوجٍ. And there are no cracks in it.
وَالْأَرْضَ مَدَدْنَاهَا وَأَلْقَيْنَا فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ وَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ.
And the earth, we spread it out and cast therein firmly set mountains and made grow therein something of every beautiful kind.
الْأَرْضَ مَدَدْنَاهَا. And the earth, we have spread وَالْقَيْنَا فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَا We have fixed mountains over it. وَأَبَّتْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ And we caused to grow therein of every lovely kind of vegetation.
تَبْصِرَةً وَذِكْرَى لِكُلِّ عَبْدٍ مُنِيبٍ
Giving insight and a reminder for every servant who turns to Allah.
Tabsiratan wa zikra. This is actually to give the mankind an insight and admonition, reminding for every person who turns to Him, to Allah.
وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ جَنَّاتٍ وَحَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ
And we have sent down blessed rain from the sky and made grow thereby gardens and grain from the harvest.
نَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا And we sent down from the heaven. The blessed water of rain. فَأَمْبَتْنَا بِهِ جَنَّاتٍ وَحَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ And with that, we made to grow the gardens and the grain of harvest. These are two things. A garden, the tree remains there. Only you pluck the fruit. But in the field, where you have this grain, the whole plant is taken off. So that is Habbal Hasid. And gardens are Jannat.
وَالنَّخْلَ بَاسِقَاتٍ لَهَا طَلْعٌ نَضِيدٌ
And lofty palm trees having fruit arranged in layers.
النَّخْلَ بَاسِقَاتٍ لَهَا And there are tall date palms. لَهَا طَلْعٌ نَضِيدٌ They have ranged clusters.
رزقا للعباد وأحيينا به بلدة ميتا كذلك الخروج
As provision for the servants and we have given life thereby to a dead land thus is the resurrection
رزقا للعباد All this we have created as a sustenance for our servants وَأَحْيَيْنَا بِهِ بَلْدَةً مَيْتَى And with this, we revive a land which had become dead. كَذَلِكَ الْخُرُوجِ In the same way you will come out from this earth one day. Where will you go? You will be in this earth. Where from did you come? From this earth. مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ And anyhow you will go there. If somebody is burnt, then the ashes, where do they go? Although you have spread it in Ganges, Sutariya, Ganga, Bahadi, and your final way will go in the ocean, then settle down. It is going to be a part and parcel of the same earth. From the earth, we take out trees, and from the earth, we will take you out. كذلك الخروج.
كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح وأصحاب الرس وثمود.
The people of Noah denied before them, and the companions of the well, and Thamud.
كَذَّبَتْ قَبْلَهُمْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ وَأَصْحَابُ الرَّسِّ وَثَمُودُ Belied before them the people of Nuh, and the dwellers of Ar-Ras, and Thamud, the nation of Thamud.
وَعَادٌ وَفِرْعَوْنُ وَإِخْوَانُ لُوطٌ
And Ad, and Pharaoh, and the brothers of Lot.
وَعَادٌ وفرعون وإخوان لوط also the Ad, the Fir'aun, and the brethren of Lut, عليه الصلاة والسلام.
وأصحاب الأيكة وقوم تبع كل كذب الرسل فحق وعيد
And the companions of the thicket and the people of Tubba all denied the messengers. So my threat was justly fulfilled.
Ashabu al-Aika and the dwellers of the wood, thick wood. That is Ashabu al-Madian. Wa qawmu Tubba and the people of Yemen, people of Tubba. Kullun kazzaba al-Rusula. All of them belied their messengers. فحق وعيد. So my threat came true on them. They were destroyed, decimated, annihilated.
أعينا بالخلق الأول بل هم في لبس من خلق جديد.
Did we fail in the first creation? But they are in confusion over a new creation.
أَفَعَيِّنَا بِالْخَلْقِ الْأَوَّلِ. Very beautiful style. What do you think? Have we been exhausted due to this first creation? Our creative potential has finished. We can't create again. No. Have we been exhausted? أَفَعَيِّنَا بِالْخَلْقِ الْأَوَّلِ. بَلْ هُمْ فِي لَبْسٍ مِّنْ خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. Actually, they are in doubt about a new creation. The shortcoming is here in your minds. Allah doesn't lack the power and authority and ability to recreate. But only you can't reach there. Your minds are low.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ.
And we have already created man and know what his soul whispers to him, and we are closer to him than his jugular vein.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ. And verily we created the man, and we very well know what his animal soul whispers into him. This id or libido, our animal instincts, what is coming up, and from, you know, our subconscious mind, these things come up, and we mostly act according to that. Even we don't know, but we are under the influence of our subconscious mind. Our id or libido is driving us. So Allah knows. Whatever is whispering is this your nafs doing with you. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. And we are nearer to the human beings than their own jugular veins. We are very subtle. You can have no conception, no perception of us. But don't think we are far away. These two things are absolutely different. We are nearer to you than your jugular veins. نَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ.
إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدِ.
When the two receivers receive, seated on the right and on the left.
إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ قَعِيدِ. Just imagine, when the two receivers, angels, receive, seated one on the right and the other on the left. We have two angels. Everybody has two angels with us. They are recording whatever we are doing. Even every word which comes out, recording.
مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ.
Man does not utter any word except that with him is an observer prepared to record.
يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ. He utters not a word. إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. But there is a watcher over him. No word goes in vain. By uttering word, either you have earned some good deed or some bad deed. With each word, these words never go in vain. Either you have sown a good seed, or you have sown a seed of a thorny bush that you will have to have in the hereafter with every word that you utter.
وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدُ.
And the intoxication of death will bring the truth. That is what you were trying to avoid.
وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. Now it's very beautiful, you know. What has happening throughout the life This is given here. Whatever we act, there are two receivers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, two angels, they are recording everything. Now, the time limit has come. Now comes the time of death. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. And then the agony of death overtakes man. ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدُ. Then someone would say to him, this was what you used to shun and avoid. Very important psychological reality. Every man tries to push away from his mind the idea of his death. He sees people dying. He joins their funerals, prays for them. But will it come to me? No. Push it away. Keep busy. Go on. You wanted to shun it. You never thought that time will come. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدُ. But now the third stage.
وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ.
And the horn will be blown. That is the day of carrying out the threat.
وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ. And then the trumpet will be blown. And that would be the day of the threat about which the messenger is warning you that day will come. What will happen? وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ. Every soul will come to the Lord, and with it will be two angels. One will be pushing him, go ahead. The other will be carrying the record. This is his book of deeds with me. That's to testify, witness.
جاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد.
And every soul will come, with it a driver and a witness.
جاءت كل نفس معها سائق, driver, pusher, وشهيد, and a witness.
قد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد.
It will be said, you were certainly in unmindfulness of this, and we have removed from you your cover. So your sight this day is sharp.
لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ هَذَا. It will be said to them, you have been heedless of this day. You didn't think that it will come. You thought, these are the stories of the ancients. They have no reality. لَقَدْ كُنْتَ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مِنْ هَذَا. فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءَكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. Now we have taken away the veil or the curtain which was before your eyes. Now, today your sight is piercing. You can see everything. All the fundamental truths of this universe and creation, now you are seeing them.
وَقَالَ قَرِينُهُ هَذَا مَا لَدَيَّ عَتِيدٌ.
And his companion, the angel, will say, this record is what is with me prepared.
فَقَالَ قَرِينَهُ هَذَا مَا لَدَيَّ عَتِيدٌ. And now his companion will say, this is he who was in my charge. It is his present.
أَلْقِيَا فِي جَهَنَّمَ كُلَّ كَفَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ.
Allah will say, throw into hell every obstinate disbeliever.
أَلْقِيَا فِي جَهَنَّمَ كُلَّ كَفَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ. It will be said, both of you, because two angels will be coming with them, with every soul, one driving and one carrying the record, that is the witness. So to them there will be the command, cast you both into hell, every ungrateful and stubborn one.
مَنَّاعٍ لِلْخَيْرِ مُعْتَدٍ مُرِيبٍ
Preventer of good, aggressor and doubter.
مَنَّاعٍ لِلْخَيْرِ مُعْتَدٍ مُرِيبٍ Who was hinderer of the good. He wanted to put obstacles in the way of good and truth. مُعْتَدٍ transgressor, مُرِيب and doubter.
الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد.
Who made as equal with Allah another deity, then throw him into the severe punishment.
الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر. Who set him with Allah another god. فألقياه في العذاب الشديد. Now throw him in the very severe chastisement.
قال قرينه ربنا ما أطغيته ولكن كان في ضلال بعيد.
His devil companion will say, Our Lord, I did not make him transgress, but he himself was in extreme error.
قال قرينه. Now the Satan with every soul, we have read before, for every human being there is a Satan also. Now that Satan will say, رَبَّنَا مَا أَطْغَيْتُ Oh my Lord, I never led him astray. وَلَكِنْ كَانَ فِي ظَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ He himself was in the error far away. I shouldn't be thrown into the fire with him. I never led him astray. He himself was wrong in error.
قال لا تختصموا لدي وقد قدمت إليكم بالوعيد.
Allah will say, Do not dispute before me, while I had already presented to you the warning.
قال لا تختصموا لدي. Allah will say, Now you don't quarrel with each other before me in my presence. وقد قدمت إليكم بالوعيد. And I had already sent you the warning.
مَا يُبَدَّلُ الْقَوْلُ لَدَيَّ وَمَا أَنَا بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ
The word will not be changed with me, and never will I be unjust to the servants.
وَمَا يُبَدَّلُ الْقَوْلُ لَدَيَّ مَا يُبَدَّلُ الْقَوْلُ لَدَيَّ Nothing can be changed in my presence. No words can be changed. وَمَا أَنَا بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ Nor I am unjust and cruel to my servants, all creation, whether a kafir or a Muslim, they are all my creation. I am not going to be unjust to anyone. The kafir disbeliever or the opposer of the truth, well, he will have what he did, that's all. And those who did good deeds, served Allah and His deen, they will have their reward.
يوم نقول لجهنم هل امتلأت وتقول هل من مزيد
On the day we will say to hell, have you been filled? And it will say, are there some more?
يوم نقول لجهنم هل امتلأت Imagine the day when we shall say to the hell, are you filled up? وَتَقُولُ هَلْ مِنْ مَزِيدٍ And it will say, Are there any more? I'm ready to take more.
وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ
And paradise will be brought near to the righteous, not far.
وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ At the same time, the paradise The garden will be brought nearer to those people who were muttaqis, who were God-fearing in the world. And that garden was not very far off.
هذا ما توعدون لكل أواب حفيظ.
It will be said, "This is what you were promised," for every returner to Allah and keeper of His covenant.
And it will be said, "هذا ما توعدون لكل أواب حفيظ." No, this is what you were promised. For each one who keeps on returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is always remembering and repenting.
من خشي الرحمن بالغيب وجاء بقلب منيب.
Who feared the most merciful unseen and came with a heart returning in repentance.
من خشي الرحمن بالغيب. Who feared Rahman, the compassionate, in the unseen. وَجَاءَ بِقَلْبٍ مُنِيبٍ. And he has come here with a heart which is penitent. قَلْبٍ مُنِيبٍ, قَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. This heart, you have not polluted it with bad deeds. The Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you commit something, some wrong, some sin, there is a black dot on your heart. If you repent, it is cleared. If you repeat, another dot. Repeat another dot. Till that time that the whole heart becomes black. And it becomes like this. Closed. Now, no good sermon, no good reminding, no good admonition can enter it. But whosoever brought the heart in a healthy, a natural way, he had kept it as a trust of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and brought it back to Allah. Said, for him, man khashiya rahmana bil ghaib wa jaa bi qalbi munib. For them the garden is here.
Udkhuluha bi salam. Thalika yawmul khulud.
Enter it in peace. This is the day of eternity.
Udkhuluha bi salam. Now enter it, enter this garden with peace, having no fear. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُلُودِ. This is the day of ever abiding. You have to live here forever and ever.
مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ.
They will have whatever they wish therein, and with us is more.
لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. They will have in that garden whatever they will wish to have. And we have more. What is that more? فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ. Many things which we can never imagine here in this world. Those bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever we know, whatever we wish, whatever we can wish, whatever we can desire for, all these things will be already present. And then whatever you call for, whatever you demand, whatever you order, it will be presented. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ.
وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ هُمْ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ بَطْشًا فَنَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ هَلْ مِنْ مَحِيصٍ.
And how many a generation before them did we destroy, who were greater than them in striking power, and had explored throughout the lands? Is there any place of escape?
وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ. How many a generation we destroyed before them. They were more mightier in their prowess. فَنَقَبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ. So they penetrated the lands, conquering this area, that area, devastating that area. All big nations do this. When they have might and power, they trample the earth. فَنَقَبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ. هَلْ مِنْ مَحِيصٍ. Was there any place of refuge for them? When the command of Allah came and they were to be destroyed, they couldn't find any refuge for them.
إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كان له قلب أو ألقى السمع وهو شهيد.
Indeed, in that is a reminder for whoever has a heart or who listens while he is present in mind.
إن في ذلك لذكرى لمن كان له قلب أو ألقى السمع وهو شهيد. This ayah is very important. Quranic psychology. Definitely in this is a reminding for that person who either has a heart or he gives his ear while he is mindful. Now there are certain persons whose heart are healthy at their natural state. They get the guidance directly. Just as the revelation came to the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam directly, not through these ears, no. He didn't hear Jibreel with these ears, no. It was a direct descending on the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now if you have a sound heart, Allah's guidance will come to you directly, without your effort. If there are certain curtains, some obstructions, then you have to listen carefully and mindfully. That is the second way of getting guidance. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعَ. Or he gives his ear fully. وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. And he is mindful, attentive.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوبِ.
And we did certainly create the heavens and earth and what is between them in 6 days, and there touched us no weariness.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ. And verily, and correctly, and surely, we created the heavens and the earth and whatsoever is in between them in 6 days. Now this subject has been repeated in the Quran several times, 6 days. And I have been saying we can't understand these 6 days. We should say 6 cycles of time, 6 periods of time. Maybe at some time, whenever knowledge of cosmology and the knowledge about the creation of the universe advances, maybe we understand it, but not up till now. But here something has been added. وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوبٍ. And no fatigue or weariness touched us. Why? Because it is in Torah, the book of Genesis, that Allah created this universe in 6 days, and on the 7th day He rested. This is, you know, how the human mind crept into these books. Because the real Torah disappeared from the world in the year 587 BC, when Nebuchadnezzar destroyed Jerusalem and everything was destroyed. Temple was razed to the ground. Torah was lost. After about a century and a half, it was rewritten from memory. So here in this rewriting of Torah, the human concepts, they entered. And this is human concept. When you work for 6 days, then you need 1 day rest. So they thought, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala worked very hard to create this whole universe in 6 days. So on the 7th day, they took rest. Allah says, no. We are inexhaustible. Our energy is never exhausted. We never feel tired. We don't need any rest. وَمَا مَسَّنَا مِنْ لُغُوبٍ. No weariness even touched us.
فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ.
So be patient, O Muhammad, over what they say, and exalt Allah with praise of your Lord before the rising of the sun and before its setting.
Asbir ala ma yaqulun. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, now endure with patience whatever they are saying. I told you that in the first 3 years of his ministry, this is a Christian term, when Muhammad started sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his mission, for 3 long years, the persecution that came from the kuffar was, number one, only verbal. No physical assault for 3 years. And number two, this verbal persecution was also centered on the personality of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam only. So that if we can kill his will, everything will be okay. Why to beat others? If his will is killed, he loses heart, he gives up this tabligh, well, okay. That is why you will find in these early surahs, فَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ. In Surah Al-Muzzammil, فَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَحْجُرْهُمْ حَجْرًا جَمِيلًا. So you have to show patience on what they are saying about you. And we read in Surah Al-Hijr, وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّهُ يَزِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. We very well know that your chest shrinks on what they are saying about you. Somebody comes and says, he's a shair, he's a poet, he's a soothsayer, kahin, soothsayers. Or he is a possessed person, some evil spirit has possessed him, some jinn has possessed him. Or he gets the dictation from someone. Or he's forging a lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever they are saying about you, وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَزِيقُ صَدْرُكَ. Due to the grief, your chest shrinks. But you have to take it patiently. فَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَصَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ. And glorify your Lord with His praise. قَبْلَ طُلُعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ. Before the rising of the sun and before its setting. Two prayers in the beginning. First of all, there was only the night prayer. قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا نِصْفَهُ وَانْقُصْ مِنْهُ قَلِيلًا أَوْ زِدْ عَلَيْهِ وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. No prayer during the day. After some time, two prayers. One, that is Fajr, before the rising of the sun. Second, the Asr, before the setting of the sun. قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ غُرُوبِهَا قَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ.
وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحْهُ وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودِ.
And in part of the night exalt him, and after prostration.
وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحْهُ وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودِ. And now, out of that long standing of the night, it was, relief was given, some time of the night also. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ, from the night time also, فَسَبِّحْهُ, glorify him. وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودِ, and after the prostrations. When you have prostrated, you have prayed, then after the prayer also, that Tasbih al-Fatima, رضي الله تعالى عنها, the Tasbih that was taught by Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to his very dear daughter Fatima, you say 33 times, Subhanallah, 33 times, Alhamdulillah, 33 or 34 times, Allahu Akbar. So this is after prostration.
واستمع يوم ينادي المناد من مكان قريب.
And listen on the day when the caller will call out from a place that is near.
استمع يوم ينادي المناد من مكان قريب. And listen attentively on the day when the caller will call from a near place. And the trumpet will be blown. It will appear as if someone is calling, and not calling from very far off, from a very near place.
يَوْمَ يَسْمَعُونَ الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُرُوجِ.
The day they will hear the blast of the horn in truth. That is the day of emergence from the graves.
يَوْمَ يَسْمَعُونَ الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ. The day when they will hear an awful cry with the truth, having a very big effect. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُرُوجِ. That will be the day of your coming out from your graves. So this is the second trumpet. At first trumpet, Sa'a. Ya ayyuhan nas, ittaqu rabbakum inna zalzalata as-sa'ati shay'un 'azim. That zalzala, that earthquake, that shaking, everything will be shaken. When the mountains will move like clouds. So that is first trumpet. We have read it in Surah Zumar, in the last but what section. وَنُفِغَ فِي السُّورِ فَالصَّعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ نُفِغَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْصُرُونَ. Now this is the أُخْرَى. يَوْمَ يَسْمَعُونَ الصَّيْحَةَ بِالْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُرُوجِ. That will be the day of coming out of the graves.
إِنَّا نَحْنُ نُحْيِي وَنُمِيتُ وَإِلَيْنَا الْمَصِيرُ.
Indeed, it is we who give life and cause death. And to us is the destination.
Inna nahnu nuhyi wa numit. Verily, O mankind, you should know, it is we who keep you alive. The saying of the kafir was, nahya wa namut. We ourselves live and we ourselves die. But the reality is, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نُحْيِي. We keep you alive. You can't live by yourself. وَنُمِيتُ. And we shall make you die. وَإِلَيْنَا الْمَصِيرُ. And then to us will be your return.
يَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ الْأَرْضُ عَنْهُمْ سِرَاعًا ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ.
On the day the earth breaks away from them and they emerge rapidly, that is a gathering easy for us.
The day when the earth will split asunder from them and they will be coming out running. Sira'a. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. This is the gathering of the day of judgment, which is very easy on us. It's not hard. It's not difficult for us.
نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت عليهم بجبار فذكر بالقرآن من يخاف وعيد.
We are most knowing of what they say, and you are not over them a tyrant. But remind by the Quran whoever fears my threat.
نَحْنُ عَلَمُ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. Again that, what they are saying. We very well know. We know better than you know, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what they are saying. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارٍ. And you are not a compeller over them. You can't compel them to accept your call. We have not given you the authority. مَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطِرٍ. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِوَكِيلٍ. Here, وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارٍ. You can't compel them. They have a free choice of their own. إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. In Surah Al-Kahf. This is a free choice of every human being. And for you it is only that you can remind them, admonish them. فَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مَنْ يَخَافُ وَعِيدٌ. So admonish them. Remind them with Qur'an. Whosoever fears the threat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now what is this tazkir? As I told you before also, in our ruh, in our spirits, we have number one, the knowledge of Allah. Number two, the love of Allah. Because this has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it is dormant. sleeping. Our animal being has crushed it. Our attention is only towards our animal being. We don't pay any heed to our ruh. But when Quran comes, by the recitation of Quran, there is a sympathetic vibration. You know, sympathetic vibration. And this is the activation of that dormant consciousness of the knowledge and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is activated. The catalytic agent is Quran, but the real chemicals, they are already present in your own existence in the form of ruh.